Evening, folks. This is Best in Slot, and welcome back to the Planet Zoo campaign. We are officially 4 missions away from the end. We've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're in the final third of the game, and we're moving on to Maya's Sunshine Happiness Zoo, which looks amazing. Maya's Sunshine is an optimistic name. Maya's Sunshine Happiness Zoo promises a lot for its name and is failing to deliver on almost all of it. Built from only the cheapest of materials and subject to odd employment laws and mysteriously heavy taxation, there will be a lot of challenges if you want to turn this ship around before it hits an iceberg.
I'm sorry we haven't met before, but I'm Emma Goodwin.
Bernie's daughter.
Oh, Nancy gave me your details. I do hope that's okay. Well, the reason I'm getting in touch is because of what Dominic Myers is doing to the profession of zoology, i.e. his wholesale destruction of it. That man should have never been allowed to purchase my family's company. His greed? It corrupts everything he touches. Still, I do want you to keep working for him, for now. See, I'm setting something up. I just can't give you details yet. But when the time is right, I sincerely hope you'll come work for me instead. Perhaps, between us, we can undo the damage Mr. Myers has done. Until then, chin up.
What do you think about this zoo, eh? It definitely has potential. Not much actual, but lots of potential. But good news, I've arranged a deal with a local building supplier, so you can use as many breeze blocks as you'd like to build here. Pretty much nothing else, though. Oh, and there's a slight legal issue with the staff. You can't fire any of them, or hire any more. Oh, except vendors. So keep the staff you've got happy, or they could be a real problem. Although not as big a problem as the local taxes, which are a very big problem. Long story short, I'm going to have to take mysteriously large yearly payments from the zoo accounts to pay for them. Anyway, you better get started. I want to see all sorts of animals here. Giraffes, cheetahs, orangutans, etc. You know, furry ones. So we won't have to spend too much keeping them warm. Although you probably will want to give a warm welcome to the reporter who's coming. I know they say there's no such thing as bad publicity, but trust me, if that was true, I wouldn't have had to buy all these zoos.
Right. Right, here we go in a bizarre-looking zoo. Really is a very, very... I mean, it's got a frickin' rocket. Why does it have a frickin' rocket? It's got a rocket. It's got like a... It's got quite a Russian vibe to it. It really does. We've got the space station over there. There's like a... Where's the radar dish that I saw before? There's a radar dish somewhere. There's a rocket looking thing over there. Whatever the hell this is. There's just a whole lot of nonsense. I don't know how else to put it. There's just nonsense everywhere. I love it. It reminds me a little bit, and I'm wondering if this was the inspiration. The Winter Olympics in... begins with an S. Where were they? Something like that. Anyway, it's the Winter Olympics. Quite a few years back now. They had like a village. You know, this looks like a village in a lot of ways. And it kind of fell apart afterwards. It's now like abandoned. And it's like this testament to the damage that the Olympics can do if poorly planned for, blah, 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 blah. Sochi! The Sochi Olympics. Sochi? I think Sochi. Anyways, the point is it looks similar. Maybe that's the inspiration. Where's that radar dish? I saw a radar dish. Is it on the mountain somewhere? Anyways, what have we got to do? Okay, we've got to obtain an overall staff happiness of at least 75%, earn a yearly profit of 1500, and adopt and place the rescue animals found in the reward section of animal trading. So what have we got in our rescues? We've got a cheetah and an orangutan, two animals perfectly suited to this location. Okay, we clearly need some staff rooms. That should be the main issue though, the lack of staff rooms. We've got what looks to be an easy exhibit set up right... Wait, what's going on here? I don't know what this is all about right there, but that looks like an exhibit right there. And that looks like an exhibit right there. So, okay, we can get our first two animals in fairly easy. Let's get some staff rooms in. First of all, how much money? We've got a little bit of money to play with. Staff facilities. What are we talking about in terms of... okay, it's pretty cool. It does have this industrial Cold War kind of aesthetic. It's maybe not one I would personally have picked for a zoo, but here we are. So I do want to put the staff center in. I'm going to try to put in here. We're going to just... I mean, I could go there. We could maybe do an exhibit there, though. That's probably a really good place for an exhibit. But I mean, we can have a staff center in. I want to get it close to the other staff centers for fairly obvious reasons. Is that going to work? No, it's not going to work. That will work. Maybe I can sit it on top of the pipes. Maybe I can't sit it on top of the pipe. I can put it there. And then I can probably justify that, and we'll make it into like a little bridge. Okay. Sexy. Alright, I can't believe that took 10 minutes. Okay, so the staff should be much happier. Yeah, we've got two more staff rooms. I suspect we have a lot of staff. Oh my god, what? We might need more staff rooms, if I'm honest. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna take this one, and we're gonna just do that, okay? Because that is an insane number of staff members. Jesus wept. He did. He was very upset. Jesus saw my staff members. He was like, bestest lad, that's too many staff members. And bearing in mind, Jesus was like turning like water into wine or whatever and made fish and bread. I can't remember what he turned into fish and bread. Did he turn bread into fish? Was that the... I don't know. I didn't read the Bible. The point is, Jesus has no problem with lots of people hanging out, right? But even he would be a bit like, whoa, Nelly, it's a little bit excessive, son. I'm gonna change the colour on these ones, just to be fancy. That's fancy, that's fancy. Going hard on the references today, folks. Hard on the references, there we go, look at that, beautiful. Right, so, next step is to bring in our two animals. Let's get our cheetah and our orangutan sent over to animal storage. I mean, that's empty, so you can go there. And that's empty, and that's bear, dog, timber, zebra, Siberian. Okay, so I guess we're going there. We may as well use the ones that have been given to us, yeah? Okay, cool. How much happier are we? Are we feeling good? Feeling sexy? Oh god, life is pain. I think we're gonna have to go through and make some of these animals a whole lot happier as well. First, let's get some of these bad boys in there, and over here. They're already kind of there. There's actually a lot I like about that. Like, this is actually a really cool little area. There's a lot of cool things about the zoo, it just maybe needs a little bit of love. Okay, I'm gonna assume that will fix itself. There are thousands upon thousands of staff rooms, my friends. Right, down to 20. It's starting to drop. Okay, cool. So we're going to stop again because these animals need... Obviously, this is not a suitable environment. We need to go through and make our animals as happy as possible. Also, where's that radar dish? It's over there! I found it. It's very cool. Look at that, just a random ass radar dish. Seriously, this is like a Call of Duty level, not a Planet Zuzu. That's right. Zuzu. So, terrain. That can't be good. Yeah, we're not big on the snow, so we're going to need some heaters. I don't know why... Myers doesn't know a bloody thing. He's like, oh, yes, yes, yes. I don't know why I'm doing the voice, but that's what we're rolling with. Oh, yes, yes, because they're furry, they won't need heating. Yes, but all the furry animals happen to live in warm climes. I like the word climes, it's a cool word. Side note, bloody Bernie's daughter pops up. Can't remember her name. Sam, was it? I don't remember. And she's all like, you know, do what I want kind of thing. I'm not sure I approve. Yeah, we're gonna heat that up. We'll heat that up first. Do we need plant life? No, but we're gonna give you some anyway because plants are cool. You're also gonna need some basic habitat requirement stuff. Cheetah. Sorry. Food tray right near there, and water bowl right near there. I'm gonna keep things. Keep it simple, stupid. And we're going to Africa grasslands. Anyways, she just pops up and she's like, oh yeah, you can come work for me. Just keep working for your boss. Like, she like gave me permission to keep doing my job. I don't approve the attitude I was getting. And the same with my people just pop up and keep thinking I'm gonna work for them. What about my desires? What about what Best in Slot wants? You know, nobody cares what Best in Slot wants. Nobody cares. I don't really know what I'm doing here. What do I always... Oh, my little... Yeah, just like on our franchise mode playthrough, well, Sandbox these days. African daisies hide in the rocks. That's what they do. It's what they're most known for. in my universe. Okay. That should be a moderately happy cheetah pretty soon. Once that's warmed up. We need to get our vet research going on the cheetah. Oh my god, we've got tiger. We've got so many animals. That's actually nuts. On the cheetah and on the orangutan. Because they're going to have very, very different enrichment needs. Now, you, my friend, you're next on my list. Let's get you nice and toasty, shall we? Because I... Big stab in the dark here, but I'm going to assume orangutans not a big fan of the freezing cold. Also... Oh no, he's a lonely orangutan. Can I do anything about this? I strongly suspect not. Oh, sweet. Female. I'm gonna get you a dude. Okay, there we go. No, they'll be happy together and they have little babbies and everyone wants little babbies, right? Okay, we need climbable area, we need I'm gonna wait again for the heat to come on for that. We need hard shelter, we need climbable area. We'll have to wait a little bit for the enrichment stuff. Okay, I have a little shelter. Stick that against the wall. Okay, that's awful. Let's just grab that. I always like to sink the floor into the earth from whence it came. What else do we need? We need a feeder. It's going to have to be a feeder platform. I hate feeder platforms from the bottom of my heart. I really, really do. I always struggle with my zookeepers not using the feeder platforms for some reason, so I tend to put one on the floor. And then we need to build like a little a thing, a climbing thing. So I guess we're going to do that. Let's go big over here. And go down a little bit. I don't know what I'm doing, but it's gonna be a thing. Okay, looking sexy. Climbable platform. Stick you on top. Stick you on top. On top. Thank you. You are humongous. Maybe I can link these two together. Nearly. Okay. If we just go all the way down. It's a ramp. It's a ramp to nowhere, but it's a ramp. I love it. If I know one thing about orangutans, and I don't, that they love a good ramp. I mean, who doesn't love a good ramp? Look at that, that's sexy. Okay. What do we want atop the ramp? It can't just be a bloody ramp, best in slot, you nerd. Alright, so we need this thing. We need the Y. If you manage to approach the top, you will get given the Y of power. I'm going to put that along, I'm going to move this up, and then if you manage to climb the Y of Power, you'll receive an even bigger Y of Power. We're going to move that a little bit up, like so. Lovely stuff. Okay, and this is the easy way. We're going to grab that, we're going to put on angle snap, we're going to flip it a flip, like so, and there we go. That's pretty cool anyway. I'm not sure that's going to... This Y of Power needs to be a little bit higher up, I would say. We're just climbing. Oh wait, that's just going to escape. No, we obviously can't do this. They will literally just climb out of the enclosure at this rate. Hopefully that's... Okay, what we can do, we're going to grab all of it, and we're just going to give it a little rotate. Then they're less likely to, you know, do a runner, which sounds like a good plan to me. Now we can bring this up again. The Wise of Power. Duplicate that, give it a flip, and we are done. Right, play. You're going to be a little bit unhappy for a minute, my friend. I'm going to sort you out ASAP, okay? ASAP. I'm just waiting for the heaters to do their thing. Okay, we're looking good over here. We're getting there, we're getting there. Slow down time. Oh, I don't see cheats very often in this game. Right, enrichment, obviously not good. Habitat, terrain. You seem happy. What's the problem? Ah, there we go. Oh, you'll be fine. Okay, so that should be okay. What about over here? You're going to need a little bit more love, aren't you, my friend? Yes. So, we need more climbable. I think about our trees, they count. Let's get the terrain sorted first. What are we doing? We need less grass, oddly enough. And more dirt. It's a dirty orangutan. Yeah, there we go. It's a little too much snow. I'm gonna keep them toasty. I'm gonna say. I love my animals. Gonna look after them. Plants. Obviously, we need plants as well. This is gonna be a weird ass looking exhibit. Right, so we're not in Africa anymore. We are in Asia, and we're heading to the rainforest. Tropical Asia. Cool. Big fan of this set. This is, of course, my pen ride. That very first thing we ever built. This was a rainforest enclosure. I think that should count for this. I want to see. It doesn't. Interesting. But it did. Okay. Put some more plants in. Like, we don't need to put more plants in, but we can't only put those in, can we? That would be silly. Gotta get your custard apple on. Custard apple trees are amazing. Look at them. They're awesome. They can be a bush. I know how much people love it when I sink plants into the ground. So obviously we should do it at every available opportunity. Yeah, we can build something. Okay, looking here. The ground's always going to look a little weird. It's all very drained of colour, you know? That's okay. We can work with that. We can work with that. It's just a happy little accident, folks. It's a happy little accident. Okay, whatever. Oh, what's this? You didn't see this? That's very cool. Ah, they've made a wolf. I like it. Okay, we need more. How much money have I got? I've got enough. We need to finish off our weird building sitch. So I'm gonna do a platform there, along there. Okay, you were meant to be straight, but that's fine. Need a big old stick, don't we all? Where's my big old stick? Let's not answer that question. Right, there we go. And then up a little bit. I like it when it pokes out a little. I do. I like it when it pokes out a little bit. I can't change what I've said. I meant it. It just looks cool. It looks more real, like it's actually been constructed rather than made in a video game, you know? I wish there was a way to change that. You know when you grab an item and the angle, like I'm moving it now, what I want to do is move it down that way. It'd be nice if there's an easy way to do that. I can see why that would be a very complex thing to do, don't get me wrong, but it would be handy. Maybe there is a way to do it. There's definitely things about resetting the axis to a world axis into a global axis and stuff like that, but I haven't really taken a look at it. Okay, cool. I mean, there is an easy way to do this. It just feels a little cheap. What you can do is literally just... not this. Stick sticks in, and it kind of works. But we can make it look a little cooler. Give it a little spin to it, you know? Make it like a separate way up onto the platform. We're gonna get that, folks. We're gonna get that. 22 minutes already. Bloody Nora. Right, okay. How are we doing? How are we feeling? Are we good? Are we feeling sexy? I'm gonna stop saying sexy. It's like 8 in the morning right now. It's too early. It's just too early. Environment, we're looking good. Terrain, we're nearly looking good. We're not quite there yet. Loan cash, that's fine. Probably. Somehow. Okay, my theory is that this looks okay. But it should also count for their climbing need. Eh? Okay, that's fair. Look, they auto-unbox now. It's amazing. For the longest time, they didn't auto-unbox, and it was really annoying. It's actually so much better now. Social. Still not good. It's actually, like, I think it's just because of this. It's a climbable area. It counts as social. I don't want to keep putting stuff in because I'm not very good at this. This is not my specialty, to say the least. So I don't really want to go like overboard on this stuff, you know. I'm gonna cheap out just a little bit. We're just gonna go like that. Everything looks fine. just let me keep sticking sticks everywhere, okay? We're gonna do some slightly rotated, topsy turvy platforms. Come on, you must be happy now. How are we doing? How are we living? We're the happiest orangutans in the world. It hasn't gone up. I swear to God, it doesn't go up. I'm just gonna put a stick in and we're gonna see what happens, right? It was 131. What's it on now? 134. God. Okay, we're gonna do this all the way along to there. That's gonna join onto there, and then we need a little one. You can do so much climbing here. So much climbing. Okay. How we living? We good? We good? We've got to be good, right? Yeah. Okay, apparently there's still... If I get rid of this stuff... Wait, there's heater right there. What's it doing? Why is it being weird? Oh, right, no power. There we go, just about. Another one there. And that should be okay. Get rid of all the snow. Right, all the staff are happy. Except this dude. He's the only one. Earl Lorenzo or something. Tickets can go up a little bit. Right. So. 60, really? 63%? Really? Are they underpaid or something? Oh, wow. Yeah, okay. Huh. I thought there's like a quick... Unless I'm crazy, I thought there's like a quick button to fix... The wages. They're all unhappy with their staff wage. Oh my god. There's got to be a way to do this quickly. There has to be. I guess I can set it to 200. And see. Alright, that's totally not enough. Oh my god, okay. 300. There we go, 250. Okay, that's one way to do it. Oh, you know you're not getting that much, son. Okay, what do you want? I'm gonna give you 1,000. I'm gonna give you 1,100. Okay, there we go. So what's the last one? I can't do it for some reason. Okay, there we go. I assume it's the same for the mechanics. Go. 300. Nice. 250. Can we get away with that, maybe? Nice. Why it doesn't work sometimes. I mean, it's dependent slightly on where you move your mat. Oh my god, this is so many vendors. They better be bringing in the cash after all this, I swear. It's actually nuts. Okay, we're getting there. 1,100, right? Yeah. Whew, okay. We have happy staff. We have seemingly absolutely insane profit. My money has actually jumped off so much. So let's click on that bad boy. Total profit is 10,000. It's November, so that's actually about to finish. I'm just waiting on my staff. We're 65 right now. Why? What's wrong? I can't fix your high workload. There's no way this is only 65%, right? Why are you unhappy? Maybe what I need to be doing is setting work zones. But the idea of setting work zones for this many staff members is inherently depressing. The number is climbing. Somewhat slowly, but it is climbing. Yeah, there's my profit. 69. Let's check in on our animals then. We have quite a few, so I'm going to speed through that. I'm actually losing money all of a sudden. 71. We're getting there. So, animals. Who have we got in our park? We have a tortoise somewhere, apparently. In here? Oh, is this... Okay, that's a tortoise exhibit. There's no way you're this happy. Yeah. I think a lot of the animals need a little something to sort themselves out, you know? So, we can do that. That can be our job for the rest of the video. The problem is that we probably lack enrichment items. Yeah. Okay, well, who just got their vet research done? Oh, both. Okay. Well, let's have a little look. Little look saying species. Borneo. What do we get? Yeah, we got a re. Yes, that's beautiful. I want it. Give me. Come here. There we go. We have black rice. And that should do a lot for the orangutan. Where's my orangutan? There they are. How are we feeling? We're feeling good. Toy enrichment is a little bit low, so we'll keep that going for now. And they're also hungry, which makes sense because they've literally never been fed in their entire lives. Empty. No, that's ink. No, that's not. No, it's not empty. Oh, it's called empty. That's fine. Whatever. You can't even tell if there's a bunny in orangutan. Wow, rude. I'm going to call the keeper into here. I'll get you a toy, buddy. We'll get you a toy. Let's check up on the cheetahs. See if we can get a toy for those bad boys. Or bad girl. I'm really unsure. Yes, we have one. So again, we need to keep these here because we need to try and get a food enrichment. But we do have three vets. So I'm going to get the other one onto the Aldebra. Just there. Okay. How are we doing? 74. Come on. Come on. A little bit more. A little bit more. Just 1%. There we go. Beautifully timed.
Ah, I see you've made room for all those animals I rescued from nearby. I don't know about you, but I'm constantly surprised by the types of animals you just find wandering around the Siberian tundra.
Who lives here? Hello? Aww. Are you all on? Oh, you're so cute! Wait, do you not? Wait. Do we only have a single baby Timberwolf? That is totally unacceptable. Oh, he's all on his own! No, that's not okay. It's not okay at all. Where's the. Where's this. Okay, whatever. Timber. Wolf. Okay, it's not much. I'm gonna get you an adult. You can't live here on your own, you're a child. God, right, same with the zebra is on his own as well. Zebras, again, are, you know, not animals that should be on their own. I know, it's so sad. Enrichment is terrible as well. Oh, Myers, you aren't half a dick, are you? I'm sorry, he just is. He's just a terrible person. This is unacceptable. Anything? No. Sometimes when you research for another animal, you'll unlock for, obviously, like, you don't have to research each enrichment item for each animal. You unlock the item, you don't unlock it for an animal. So sometimes there's a lot of crossover. Unfortunately, not with the zebra, but we can at least try to get it a friend or two. Plain zebra. There we go. Yeah, okay. Cool. A dude and a dudette. Wait, what if I got them on? Yeah, okay, that's fine. Now, the exhibit does look like, I think we'll probably have to extend the exhibit because I think this is probably too small for three zebras, but I'm sorry, buddy. I'm going to get you some stuff soon, okay? Don't you worry. Don't you worry. You want a little bit more? I'll get you a little bit more grass. That's fine. Oh, we can do that. Maybe we can't. Yeah, the exhibit is already too small for one zebra, never mind two, so. Yeah, we're going to have to extend that. We'll do that in the next video. I really feel bad for the zebra. Why does it have a kiln? How bizarre. It's got like a little chimney. This is such a weirdo zoo. Honestly, it's bizarre. Hermatviv. I have to do a Russian accent. Stick a blep. All my Russian has been learned from playing Dota 2 when everyone's Russian in Dota 2, as it happens, or Peruvian if you happen to play on the American service. What's that say? Zoha. It's like Doha. It's very cool. It's just very weird at the same time. There's a lot of things that just don't. Like, what's this? Is it like an emergency bunker? I think so. It's like a security bunker. Like a nuclear holocaust kind of bunker. Oh, it's just mad. I really like this river bit. It's very cool that the whole thing's kind of split in half by this river and then the bridge crosses over. I really would like the idea of making a zoo like that. We might bring that into our African zoo a little bit. Just have no animals or anything, just a bridge section. You'd have like maybe one big fancy bridge and then some side bridges. Right, anyways. So. Next video, what do we need to do? Right, we're on to this. Done that one already. Bingo bango. We need to place a lion. We need to place giraffes. We need to place another cheetah. So we can place another cheetah in here. We're going to bring the giraffe in with the zebra. And we'll make that much bigger. And we'll have to make a new one for the lion. Going to have to get some. How am I meant to keep crime down? I can't hire security. No idea how I do that. No idea how I make my staff happier. Give them more money, I guess. breed a cheetah, breed a orangutan. Adopt an animal from each biome. Right. Okay, cool. So, next video. We'll do stuff. It's going to be cool. Thank you for joining me. I hope you're excited about this stage of the playthrough. The campaign is not going anywhere. Yes, it's not always super fast, but I'm determined to see it through to the end. I know it's been God, the game came out in November, right? So November, December, January, February. It's been like 4 months now we've been working on it, but it's just a nice thing to come to once or twice a week. I've really enjoyed it. Hope you folks are too. I'll see you a little bit later on. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.